Greetings. We are the Guardian. Welcome to Night Vision. I was at a prayer meeting recently where someone brought up the issue of the culture wars. Their fear was that the culture clashes that we see occurring globally, and in our own nation, would escalate into actual war, even civil war. In reality, the culture wars may be escalating, but they have been around since the Garden of Eden, where a difference of opinion led to division and conflict, even murder, as brother rose up against brother. In America, the slide came in the 1800s, as many in the scientific field began to embrace Charles Darwin's fairy tale of evolution. Darwin was a minister with a degree in theology who lost his faith when his young daughter passed away. He decided to walk away from his creator, and in his anger, take as many people with him as he could, and he succeeded, for a while. We now know that Darwin's theory of evolution is invalid. There is no mechanism within the theory to cause species-to-species transformation. The four horsemen of evolution, time, chance, mutation, and natural selection, can only cause a species to adapt to its environment, not turn a snake into an elephant. But it wasn't until the 1920s, that we saw the creation versus evolution culture wars, enter into the legal arena, via the public school system. The Scopes monkey trial pitted the government, against God. The end result was that the public school system began teaching the theory of evolution as fact. Shortly thereafter, in 1963, the government took the next logical step, and outlawed prayer in school. The end result, is what you see happening in the streets of America. Violence. If you teach that all life is nothing more than a biological accident, the enemy is allowed to accomplish two vital goals. Number one, you eliminate the child's self-esteem, and you replace it with false pride, and number two, you create an atmosphere of death. No respect for life leads to violence in the street, and even violence in a mother's womb. This was then legalized by the government in 1973, in the Roe versus Wade decision where the government said human life is of no value. Replacing God with science was wrong. Taking prayer out of school was wrong. But God hates the shedding of innocent blood, and to legalize the murder of an unborn child is beyond comprehension, and is not only the embodiment of evil, it is literally inexcusable from any ethical or logical perspective. Many believing parents have had to deal with the grief of a child falling prey to the deceptions of their society, their culture wars. I grieve with you, my friend. But don't feel like a failure. If you did your best to point your children in the right direction, but they chose defiance instead, you are not alone. Once again, if we go all the way back to the Garden of Eden, Adam and Eve actually had to deal with not only rebellion amongst their children, but even murder. When Cain killed Abel, that was not only an horrific event in human history, it foreshadowed the very death of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Cain represented the world, and Abel, with his acceptable sacrifice, represented our perfect Savior. And just as Cain killed Abel, the world killed Jesus. But 3 days later, the suffering servant became the risen King. He, who knew no sin, became sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God. So do not fear the culture wars. Do not fear mankind. Do not even fear death, for death has been defeated at the cross. Remember, there is no body in that tomb. Jesus only needed to borrow the tomb for 3 days. Hallelujah, he is risen. Peace be unto you, and your house. Amen.